Minnesota's city-owned liquor stores apparently fared very well during the first year of the pandemic.
Net profits were way up in 2020 compared to 2019, according to a new report from the state auditor. John Croman takes a deeper dive into today's numbers.
This is one of four liquor stores owned by the city of Lakeville. Turns out that that city's municipal liquor operation led the state last year in both sales at $18 million and in net profits at $1.7 million. That's according to the new annual municipal liquor report from State Auditor Julie Blaha.
25th consecutive year of record-breaking sales for Minnesota's municipal liquor stores.
Blaha's team found statewide city-owned liquor stores' net profits jumped $8 million in 2020, a 29% increase over 2019.
So we do owe a debt of gratitude to all of those employees that figured out plexiglass and figured out distancing and figured all that out early in the pandemic.
The other side of the story came with so-called on-sale liquor. In other words, city-owned bars like the Wyzetta Bar and Grill that serve liquor on premises. Statewide in 2020, on-sale profits dropped 11% compared to the year before.
You could have a store that's making only a little bit, maybe even having a slight loss, but because they provide a service to their community, they're doing exactly what their neighbors want.
For example, in the small town of Dalton, the goal is to clear $10,000 a year so they can give $100 property tax breaks to each of the 100 households in town.
Now, under state law, any city that loses money on its liquor operations in 2 years out of a three-year period has to hold a public hearing so local people can weigh in on whether or not it's worth still being in the booze business.
Now again, this is not telling you what you need to do, just you have to talk about it. Bring your community together and have a conversation.
That's one reason the state collects information on city-owned liquor stores to help communities decide what works best for them. John Croman, Care 11 News.
Well, only those cities with less than 10,000 in population can get into the liquor business. So the larger suburbs with stores are the ones that got into the business back when they were still small towns.